You're in France and you're on vacation. You have state-of-the-art navigation in your car. What could possibly go wrong? Voicescapes Audio Theater presents Misdirections, based on certain events that kind of sort of happened. Day one.
Isn't this exciting? We're going to be driving around the countryside of France.
We're not going to be driving. I'm going to be driving.
Well, at least you're not driving on the wrong side of the road like when we were in England.
Yeah, that is true.
And besides, I'm going to help navigate. I brought lots of road maps. Local, national, I've got us covered.
I told you, we don't need 15th century technology in a 21st century world. I brought our GPS from home.
Yeah, but just in case.
No, just in case. Trust me, this is all we need.
I'm still not sure how well it's going to work over here.
It's going to work just fine. I've downloaded the entire map of Europe onto this thing.
In 1/10 of a mile, turn right.
See? It's on the job.
Turn right.
Wow, this road is pretty narrow.
Narrow? We barely fit on it.
Continue on road for 2 miles.
2 miles? On this cow path? Are you kidding me?
I hope this is one way.
I don't think that truck coming at us thinks it's one way.
Oh my God!
There's a truck coming right at us!
Move over!
Move over where? Look out the friggin' window. There's a trench on one side and a cliff on the other.
Oh my God! That was close.
Close? I could smell that guy's cologne.
And he didn't even slow down.
I know the French have a reputation for being crazy drivers, but Jesus.
Just a minute. The real map says that there's a main road that can get us to our B&B much faster.
So what? At home, the GPS is always trying to take us on back roads.
Which is why I ignore it and stay on the highway.
Well, you can do that back home where you're familiar with the area. But here, the GPS knows way more than we do, so we just have to trust it to do its thing.
Truck!
Oh, crap!
I think that GPS is trying to kill us!
It's not trying to kill us. It's just a machine.
Exactly. A machine. You've watched all the Terminator movies. This is probably how it all started, with homicidal GPS units.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. It's just a...
truck!
Day two.
In 1/10 of a mile, enter roundabout.
Roundabout? What the hell is that?
I think it's a traffic circle.
Oh, crap. I hate those things.
Enter roundabout and take the third exit.
Okay. That's exit number one.
No, it's not. That's not an exit.
Well, yes, it is. They're all exits. That's number two.
Are you sure?
Yes. That's exit three. Go. Go there!
No. The next one is the third. I'm taking that one.
Recalculating.
What?
I told you.
As soon as possible, make a U-turn.
All right. So, I may have been wrong. Let's try this again.
Enter roundabout and take fourth exit.
Fourth exit? I thought we were supposed to take the third.
Well, we were coming from a different direction then.
Oh, yeah, right. Which one's the fourth?
That one.
Okay.
Recalculating.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Oh, maybe that was the third one.
In 2/10 of a mile, enter roundabout.
Another one? You gotta be kidding me.
They're very popular in Europe.
They're stupid.
You know, you don't have to get off the roundabout.
I don't want to get on the roundabout.
No, you can just keep going around and around in the roundabout until you're sure what exit you want to take.
Oh, I never thought of that.
In 1/10 of a mile, enter roundabout and take third exit.
Okay, here we go. One, two...
Wait, that sign says Dijon. That's where we're going.
But that's not the third exit.
But that's where we're going. Take it! Take it!
No! We should just trust the GPS. It always gets us there. We're taking the third exit.
Which one is the third? I forgot where we came in.
We came in that way.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. I think I'm sure.
Exit roundabout. Recalculating.
Damn it!
We're only here for 2 weeks. Do you think we'll make it back to our B&B by then?
Don't worry. It's only our second day. We'll get the hang of it.
In 1 mile, enter roundabout.
Oh, for God's sake.
Day 3.
Wait a minute. The lady at the B&B said the chateau was only a half hour away. We've been driving for over an hour.
I'm aware of that.
Maybe it's because you're driving so slowly.
That's because I want to live to see this goddamn chateau. I mean, look at this road.
It looks like all the other roads we've been on.
Exactly. It's tiny. Everything in France is tiny. Tiny little coffee cups, tiny little closets for toilets inside tiny little bathrooms, tiny cars, and tiny, twisty, narrow roads with no shoulders. I mean, you never know what's going to come at you around the next corner.
Camper van!
Ah! Hey, I get it. I get it now. I understand why the French invented existentialism. I mean, what's the point of life? I mean, it could all end around the next turn. If not that one, then the next. It's just a matter of time, so why bother?
Maybe the GPS is taking us to the wrong chateau.
It's taking us to the right chateau.
You're sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
You put in the right address?
Yes, I put in the right address.
Are you sure you put in the right country?
Yes, I put in the right country.
We could be going to a chateau in Belgium.
We are not going to Belgium.
Well, the roads may be wider there.
We are going to Belgium.
I was just kidding.
No. Wider roads, we are going to Belgium.
Later on that day, on the way back from the chateau.
In 1/10 of a mile, take ramp onto highway.
Highway?
Wait, France has highways?
Take ramp to A6 north.
Wait a minute. This isn't how we got to the chateau. Why is the GPS taking us on a totally different route back?
Holy crap, look at this. A 3-lane highway.
It took us on windy, treacherous roads for an hour and a half through the middle of nowhere when there was a friggin' highway that could get us there?
Look at that! The sign says 110 is the speed limit!
Why would the GPS do that?
Look at me! I'm doing 110 miles an hour!
It's kilometers, hon. You're only doing 75.
Who cares? The speedometer says 110!
We should be back to the B&B in less than 15 minutes!
Doing 110? Hell yeah!
But why would the GPS do this to us? Why didn't she just take us this way to begin with? Does she have a warped, twisted sense of humor?
Who cares? We're on a highway!
I am telling you, this GPS is messing with us. She's letting us know that we are at her whim. She can make our lives easy or miserable. We're at her mercy!
In 1 mile, take exit and enter roundabout.
Crap.
See?
Day 6.
Come on, we're going to be late. We have a reservation for 8 p.m.
I know, but I can't find the restaurant in the GPS. I gotta put the address in manually.
It's a 2-star restaurant. How can it not be listed? This is France. We're going to be late.
Wait, I got it. Google Maps.
What?
Google Maps, it's on my smartphone. See, here's the restaurant, and it gives directions too.
In 1/10 of a kilometer, proceed to highlighted routes.
See, this is great. We have a backup to our GPS.
Why does the Google lady have an English accent?
I don't know, maybe it makes her sound intelligent.
And why is she talking in kilometers?
I don't know. I don't care. All I know is that we now have two computers that'll make sure we don't get lost.
Go to highlighted route.
Go to highlighted route.
See?
In 1/2 mile, turn left.
In 0.8 kilometers, turn right.
What?
Great. Now two machines are trying to kill us.
Left turn ahead.
Right turn ahead.
What do I do?
Well, the sign to Gord points straight ahead.
Turn left.
Turn right.
Stay straight!
This is a nightmare. I got three women telling me where to go.
Recalculating.
Oh my God, we're never going to get there.
As soon as possible, make a U-turn.
In 0.4 kilometers, enter roundabout.
Day 7.
We have been on the road for over an hour, and I have lost hope of seeing either of the towns we plan to go to today. Actually, I've lost hope of seeing anything but cows. And more cows. I read an article about the endemic ennui and melancholy of the French. Now I get it. And I've got it.
Look, honey, let's not ruin our vacation. I mean, we're together, we're in the French countryside, and it's all beautiful. Let's just relax and enjoy it. I mean, the GPS always gets us where we're going. Eventually.
It does give new meaning to the phrase scenic route.
Yes. Remember, it's the journey, not the destination, that's important.
In 0.2 miles, turn right off the paved road.
What?
You've got to be kidding.
In 0.8 kilometers, turn right off the paved road.
I don't think it's a good idea to get off the paved road.
But they agreed. They've never done that before. I mean, it's got to be the right way.
Or they are both working together to kill us.
They're not trying to kill us.
Oh, I have to pee.
Left turn ahead.
Turn left.
I'm going for it. I'm making the turn.
Oh, great. Now I really have to pee.
In 0.1 mile, you have reached your destination.
In 0.3 kilometers, you have reached your destination.
Hold on a little longer, hon. We're almost there.
There? Where there? We're in the middle of a vineyard.
You have reached your destination.
You have reached your destination on right.
We're in a vineyard.
Yeah.
We're not at a vineyard. We are in a vineyard.
Yep. I can see that.
Want a grape?
No, I don't want a grape.
It's pretty good. Very sweet. I think it's a Merlot grape. It has a nice bouquet, robust flavor, with overtones of honey and fennel and dirt. Are you sure you don't want to try one?
I'm not sure of anything anymore.
Well, your machines have succeeded in taking your soul and my sanity. Are you happy now?
Okay, you're right. I give up. Give me the map.
The Google map?
No, the map. The old-fashioned paper maps that you brought. I know they're old school, but at least they're accurate and consistent, and they give us some modicum of control over our lives.
They're back in the room.
What?
You told me they were antiquated and a waste of paper and that we didn't need them. You said we had backups for our backups, so I left them back at the B&B.
This is the one time you actually listened to me?
Sorry, I'll never do it again.
All right, okay. I'm sorry. I'll put the address for the B&B into both units. We'll just go wherever they tell us to go, and we'll get there when we get there.
Make a U-turn, and then turn left onto the paved road.
Make a U-turn, then turn left onto the paved road.
Well, we're We're off to a good start.
Okay, breathe. Okay. Wow, and look at beautiful scenery.
Oh, look at that pretty cow. And that black one. Oh, and there's a spotted one.
You know, I think I'm actually beginning to relax and enjoy the ride.
Me too.
Recalculating.
Damn it!
Damn it! Oh, and I still have to pee!
No American tourists were harmed in the making of this sketch.
Well, that was fun. Thanks for joining us. Hope you had a good time. We sure did. Voicecapes Audio Theater featured L.J. Ganser, Elizabeth Rogers, Tom Curley, Robin Miles, and me, Barbara Rosenblatt. Plays by Tom and Ellen Curley. Recorded sound effects by Mark Wiener. And our sound engineer, Uncle Roy Yokelson. Thanks for dropping by. See you again soon.